everybody. This is Cindy Utter. Welcome to my artsy endeavors. Have fun. Hey guys, good morning. It's Cindy Utter. Oh, I forgot to get my... I'm done with my coffee. I forgot to get my orange juice. That's all right. I'll get it in a bit. First, I want to say good morning to everybody. We're going to work on my story. I know it's been a little bit since you've seen this. Sometimes I have to step away from it just because of the amount of emotions and things that come from my story. So today, what we're going to talk about, I've got a couple things I really want to talk about, but the first one is going to be a topic that I think a lot of people need to hear, and that topic is acceptance. Now, the first thing I'm going to tell you is I'm going to read this little excerpt from this book. It's called You Are Stronger Than You Know, Words of Hope and Encouragement for Someone Living with Chronic Illness, and it's a Blue Mountain Arts collection. Here's the ISBN if you want it. Okay, and I have found this book so interesting because when you have those days when you're just, oh, I don't know if I can do this anymore, it's fantastic to grab this book and just read a little, a page or two. So this is chapter 11 on my story, and acceptance doesn't mean giving up. That is huge, 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 huge. Those words alone. When I talk to people about chronic illness, they're like, well, if I accept it, what do I do? Just live with it? Well, what other choice do you have? Okay? You can live with it and be miserable, or you can accept the issue, accept what's happening, and go from there. But let me read this. It says, learning to accept the fact that you are ill, chronically ill, is essential to being peaceful and to coping creatively. But acceptance for many who are ill with ICV, invisible chronic illness, for example, my chronic illness, it's invisible to everybody else but me, okay? So, but acceptance for many who are ill with ICI, invisible chronic illness, is hampered by the fear that acceptance means giving in to the illness and therefore giving up on any attempt to live fully. But true acceptance never means giving up. Thus, accepting being ill with the ICI, the invisible chronic illness, means knowing yourself, knowing when to rest and when to work, when to play, when to watch, when to exert energy, and when to conserve it. Acceptance means admitting the truth of being sick or tired and then deciding what action is most beneficial. It means having the courage to admit at times that you can't do it, whatever the it is, and the courage to say no. Now, this was written by Paul J. Donahue, a PhD, and Mary E. Siegel, a PhD. Okay, this is huge, 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 huge in chronic illness. It took me... All right, this September will be 5 years, so I've got to say at least 3, if not 4 or more years to get to this point. Acceptance is very difficult to achieve because you have to understand, all right, this is here to stay. It's not going anywhere. I've got to deal with it. How do I deal with it? Okay, when it talks here about... acceptance means admitting the truth of being sick or tired and then deciding what action is most beneficial. That's where you have to listen to your body. If your body tells you, no, you can't go out and walk that mall, then you can't go out and walk that mall. If you do, you're going to increase your pain, you're going to get more severe pain, and then you're just plain going to be miserable. Okay? So for me, for example, walking the mall, I know at this point I can't walk a mall. So I learned a huge, huge valuable lesson when I went to CHA in January. I did not take my scooter with me. Mistake number one. I tried to walk it. Mistake number two. Okay? I came home for 4 days. I could barely walk. mistake number three. I can't say mistake number three. That was the outcome of me not listening to my body, me not accepting the fact that, you know what, my scooter's got to go with me in situations like that. Okay, I had to pay the price. And let me tell you, for those 4 days, I was completely miserable. So acceptance is huge. That doesn't mean, oh, I'm going to give up and lay here on the couch and die. That's not what that means. It means you've got to listen to your body. You've got to listen to what it's telling you. You have to know when to stop. You have to know when to say, I'm not sure if I can do that. You know, if you can't make a commitment, my friends that have stuck with me understand. For example, Friday I was asked to go out to lunch. I said, I'll let you know. And she's like, okay, no problem. So Friday, it depends on how well I am between now and Friday. You know, am I going to listen to my body when my back says, okay, you've had enough, you need to chill out? As long as I do that, then I'll be able to go to lunch on Friday. If I don't, then I won't be able to. So see, it's my choice. It's all about the choices that we make being in chronic pain. Okay, this is another one that I wanted to read, which I thought was really cool. And this is, you are a survivor. And then there's another one. You are a survivor. There will be times when you're going to need so much courage. There will be times when you'll feel like crying yourself to sleep, when your confidence is shaken, when you're scared, you're angry and confused, when you can't believe this is happening to you. Sound familiar? We've all been there. But for every one of those situations, there will also be times when you look deep inside and realize you're going to be okay. There will be times when you find out that you're such a fighter, when you discover how strong you really can be and that you're truly a survivor. And this was written by Terry Barrison, B-A-I-R-N-S-O-N, Barrison. All right? You are a survivor. Think about it. How many times have we cried ourselves to sleep? I can't live like this. I can't take this. All right? It's okay. You're going to be okay. This third one that I wanted to read today is called Know That You'll Make It Through. This is by Anna Tafoya, T-A-F-O-Y-A. How do you make it through? You face your fears. You keep your promises. You deal directly with your challenges. You get the best possible help and care. You turn to caring, positive people you know will be there for you. Okay, we all have them. There are people that will be there. There are people that understand and that will help you through this issue. You believe. You take steps to change what's needed changing. You talk it over. You laugh. You go ahead and cry. You pray. You stay involved. You live the best life you can today. When tomorrow comes, you do it all over again. You hang in there. You hold on tight to your hope. You never let go. You know deep down inside what a special person you are. And no matter what comes along, you never forget it. You stay strong. You keep the faith. And you make room for the brightest day that someday soon is going to shine in so much serenity back in your life. Anna Tafoya. So, all three of these, being a survivor, knowing that you'll make it through, and acceptance. These are all connected. It takes a long time to get to the acceptance. But the only way you can do that is really by listening to your body. Your body is going to tell you, I'm hurting, I can't do this right now. You keep doing it, your body's going to tell you, I'm hurting, I can't do this right now. I got to grab that, I'll be right back. Hi guys, alright, so that was the Hubs. When he goes to work in the morning after I'm up and about, he calls and we chat for a little bit. And it was funny, I was telling him I was doing a video on acceptance, and he says, you know, you still have a little trouble getting there. I said, yeah, I know, I have certain days. And trust me, it's not like something you're just going to do all at once and be done with it. It doesn't happen that way. See, here we go, living in denial. But, like I said, there were other emotions and stuff that I want to touch on here, but for now, I really think acceptance just needs to be talked about, because it's not easy. It's very, very difficult for acceptance. And, you know, it's a big one. Wait a minute. What I'm going to do, because I never remember, is my art guard. Let's see how we can do with it today. Because if not, my fingers just are always covered in paint and everything else. So anyways, the acceptance, like I said, the acceptance is a very difficult, it's just a dry piece off the top of the tube. It's difficult, you know, to listen to your body when you just want to go and be the person that you were. You don't want to deal with, you know, the stuff you're dealing with right now, the pain and the, but you know, the biggest lesson I have learned is the more you ignore it, the more you're going to hurt. And I don't know about you, but I don't really enjoy being in pain. I was talking to some friends the other day, and one of the things that we talked about is, isn't it strange how, you know, living in chronic pain, your pain becomes a new normal? And that's exactly what happens. You know, if you're not in that pain, it's like, oh, wow, you know. If you're not in your normal, what am I trying to say? Spit it out, Cindy. If you're not in your normal pain and you're in your increased pain, you're miserable. But you learn in your normal pain that it's normal. This is the way it's supposed to be. This is, you know, how I feel. This is my new normal, if that makes sense. And let me tell you, if you're watching this and you don't have any chronic pain, it probably doesn't make sense to you. But those of us with the chronic pain, it makes total sense. So, as you can see, I'm using Dina Wakely paints. I love her paints. They go on so nice, and I love the colors. And so what I did is I just put this yellow. I kind of like this pattern, but not, you know, I want it in the background. So this is the lemon. And I also have some of the magenta here, and I have some of the tangerine. I'm pretty sure I have a tangerine that I've started using, so. Trying to make myself use up paints that I've already got open, because I tend to get a bunch of paints and then open like 12 of them, and yeah, that's just not cool. So I'm gonna put a little bit of this orange on here, maybe. Ouch. That's one thing I will tell you I've lost, is a lot of strength in my fingers. Why? I don't know. I don't know. Just want to put a little bit of the different color in here. Just a little bit. And that might be too much, and that might be too much. I hope you can't hear my music, because the last couple of videos I did, I got dinged on my music, so I've had to turn it down even more. I hate that. I just want, you know, just want some light background music. So anyways, we're talking about acceptance, and how do we learn acceptance? For me to be where I'm at, the biggest thing I learned is, the very first thing is, it's okay to say no. That's huge. I also learned that some people are going to understand, other people will not. To those people that don't understand, I'm sorry. You know, it's just, I'm sorry, you know, this is the new way I have to do things. If you don't understand it, you know, I'm really sorry, because it's my new normal. So, does that mean that, you know, things change in friendships and stuff? Some of them do, absolutely. Others don't. The way I feel about it is, if you're a true friend of mine, or you know, want to be in my life, you got to understand. If you love me, you understand it. If you don't, well, I'm sorry for you, because this is the new me, and this is what it has to be. So now I'm just kind of doing a little bit of each, a little bit of the. I don't know why I'm getting it going in that direction. Just kind of pull it this way a little bit. Just playing with the paint, basically, until I get it how I like it. And it's getting almost where I like it. So, acceptance is not giving up. It's not like, okay, I'm just going to live miserable in pain and stay on the couch. That's not what it's about. Acceptance is about learning how to say no, knowing when enough is enough, learning how to live within your restrictions, which we'll talk about in a minute. Let me go ahead and dry this up. I'll be right back. All right, this is dry. So now what I'm going to do is, I have these acrylic sprays that I bought last time. In Phoenix, when Gina and I were together, we went into an art store there. And they're done by Marabu, M-A-R-A-B-U, and it's called Art Spray. It's a mixed media acrylic sprays. So I'm going to use these. I've got the teal and I've got the purple. So I'm just going to play around with these and see how it goes. And then I have this stencil that I got from, it's actually not a stencil. It's one of those 12 by 12 like designs that you would put on scrapbook pages or whatever. And I just decided to use it as a stencil. So I found the more paint that gets on it, the sturdier it gets. So, and I'm gonna take this stencil and lift it up, move that aside. And then I have a couple envelopes here. These I've been using for Happy Mail. So I'm just gonna put these envelopes down. Oops. And put it on there. And then just use up that extra paint. So I'll set these aside. All right, we're going to dry this up and we'll be right back. Okay, what I've got now is, I've got some hand-carved stamps here that I'm just going to play around with. These are done from erasers. Play around with. I want to do a little bit of a border with this one. So anyways, we're talking about acceptance, and it's funny because since Hub said that to me this morning, you know, I'm thinking, you know, he's right. I don't always accept it. I mean, how do I say this? It's not as though you're not accepting it because you know it's going to stay here forever. It's just sometimes the easiest way I can explain it is the pain just gets to you where you just can't take it anymore. And whether or not that has something to do with acceptance, I don't believe it does. I think that's just everybody. Anybody that's in pain, you deal with it for just so long and you're like, okay, I've had enough of this crap. You know? Oh, crap, I have two of them. I'll use this side, I guess. This is just an old eraser that I've cut apart and just played with. So, you know, when he says that, you know, I have a hard time accepting, you know, he's right. There are times when I'm just miserable. And, you know, and you think to yourself, why? Why am I the one that's got to go through this crap? You know, I was working a full-time job. I was working a career. You know, everything was good. What the heck? But, you know, it's acceptance is where 90% of the time you're like, okay, it's here. I have to deal with it. There's nothing I can do about it. You know, let's move on. Let's talk about something different, or let's do something different. And it just happens that way. I want to see if this white, I'm going to try something here. I'm just experimenting right now. I want to see if this white will pick up this stamp. This is just a flower that I made, a funky flower. I want to see. Let's see what happens. And barely. Just barely. So I'm going to have to do that in a different color. Yeah, see, I have never found a good use for white. Maybe I just have to do it on black paper. You think? Okay. Let's see. Let's do this one. Oops. So, I believe to accept something doesn't mean you have to like it, okay? It means you know you can't change it. You can't change the situation you're in as far as the pain. Acceptance also means you need to find another way to do things. What you're doing isn't working, so let's find something else. Let's find a different way to do things. Accepting also means that it's time to let go of who we were in the past, per se. For example, in the past, you know, I worked. I was an auditor. I did a lot of traveling. I did a ton of computer work. That kind of stuff. You have to learn to let go of that. This stamp, I have to tell you, I have to stop for a second. This stamp is so cool because it was given to me by Crystal Dragonfly. She sent it to me in a happy mail. Just trying to get another ink over here. Ah, why do I always do that? Hi, everybody. I always throw my ink pads around. I gotta find a different place to put this one. And I just love this stamp. Look at it. Isn't that so cool? I just love it. Perfect. Acceptance means you need to understand and know that it's time to move on. It's time to move on from that, the grief of losing everything you've lost. Moving on from asking the question over and over and over again, why me? Moving on from not understanding that it's okay. Moving on from trying to continue to do everything you did in the past that your body no longer wants you to do. Moving on from the hurt, the anger, the not understanding, the moving on from the ability, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't want to say get over it. That's not what I'm saying, because you never really get over it. But you come to an understanding that, okay, this is my new life. How can I make it the best as possible? I want to be happy. I want to have fun. I want to still do things. So how do I make that happen? Start looking into, how do you make that happen? How do you make the good times come back again? And how? And, you know, for me, it was knowing that I can't go shopping 5 days a week, which I used to be able to do. I know that if I'm going to play, I have to
either pay big time or do things while I'm playing that will lessen the pain when I'm back home again. So, for example, when I went on vacation, we knew I couldn't do the travel the whole way. So, and I'm talking about we, I'm talking about my sister, my best friend, know that, you know, it was not possible. So we planned on staying in hotels on the way down, which we did. I had my ice machine locked and loaded in my car, which thank goodness I have the ability to do that. I have the right plug-in in the car so that the entire time we were traveling, it's easier for me to drive than it is to sit as a passenger. My sister and my friend knew that. So they did offer to drive, but they knew it was better for me in the driver's seat. And the biggest reason is because I don't move around quite so much, and then I don't cause myself the intense pain. So, you know, it's about learning what your boundaries are and knowing that if you cross those boundaries, you're going to pay for it. And that's really where I'm at, is I understand that in order to do normal things, for example, get up and go get groceries. That's another example. Let me tell you about the groceries. All right. Do you have no idea how long it took me to accept the fact that I need a carry out? Let the guys, these young guys do it. Let them bend over and put the stuff in the trunk. Let them do it. When I get home, my husband brings the groceries out. You know, I can go do the grocery shopping in the most least painful way for myself, which is, you know, like I said, getting a carry out. Let the guys do it. I've got to the point where if I'm in a store and I need something that's heavy, I'll go scour the aisles until I find a guy. Hey, can you please come put this in the cart for me? I'm not allowed to lift it. And they're like, yeah, no problem. People out there aren't always cruel. They will help. And then, you know, when it comes to the register, it's like, I'm not pulling that out of there because I can't lift it. And the cashiers come around and scan whatever it is. And then when I have a carry out, you know, the guy puts it in the car. I leave it there until Hubs gets home. So basically what I'm trying to say about acceptance is knowing when you have to ask for help and knowing that it's okay. It's okay to ask for help. There's people out there that will help you. No, I can't get my baby wipes open. What the heck? And no, these are not Huggies. These are a no-name brand. I don't like Huggies, so, but I like the container. I didn't like that I got paint right there. So, you know, it's really about, you know, doing things a different way. That's the easiest thing I can say about acceptance. Give you another example, dinner. Okay, let's say, you know, we've lived on yo-yo, which in my house means you're on your own, which normally means a bagel or cereal or, you know, whatever you feel like making, which isn't much. Let's say we've had yo-yo for 4 days, and it's like, okay, I need to make a dinner. I want to make Hubs a nice dinner. Let's say I want to make him some meatloaf and, I don't know, fried potatoes and a veggie, whatever. A salad. Instead of going out there at 3 o'clock and trying to do it all at once, what I will do is I will, in the morning, let's say I make the meatloaf, put it all together, put it in the fridge. Okay. A little bit later on in the day, after I've been arting for a little while and I need to stand up or walk around, I'll go out and make the salad, put it in the fridge. There are even some days that, like for example, today, my back is it's yelling at me today. So I hear it and I understand that, you know, I can't do this all day and that's fine. I won't. But like today, I may even go out and cook the entire dinner. You know, let's say I have the meatloaf ready. I have the, you know, potatoes ready, whatever. I may go out and just cook the whole thing, you know, and put it in the fridge and then we'll warm it up tonight because I know by tonight my back's going to be like, yeah, you're done. So there's always a different way to do things. And that's what I'm trying to say. And that's part of acceptance, is understanding that, you know, you can still do what you used to do, mostly, not all the time, but mostly. And it's okay. You just find a different way of doing things. Another thing that we've had to make some changes actually here in the house. My laundry room used to be down in the basement, which we have a full finished basement. And what would happen is going up and down those stairs, by that night I was in so much pain it wasn't funny. And unfortunately I am not one to do, look at that, acceptance. I am not one to, you know, do a load here and do a load there. If I go do something, I want to get it done. So, you know, the going up and down the stairs was not working for me. So we actually took the front part of our former dining room, and my husband built a wall, and we actually made the washer and dryer, made a little laundry room there. So now I'm on the same level, so I can just go do laundry whenever I need to. Another thing we did is washer and dryers down on the floor. That's not good for a bad back. So we put them up on the, you know, they have the drawer units that you can sit them up on. Perfect. I can open the door, I can put the stuff in the dryer, I can take stuff out, not a problem. So a lot of it too is learning how to make those changes and seeing those changes that you need to make your life a little bit easier in whatever chronic pain that you're in. Even if it's anxiety or depression, there's always something different that you can do to help yourself through those feelings and through those emotions. I have a dear friend that has a huge anxiety disorder. I talk to her quite often, and you know, she'll be like, I'm freaking out over this. Okay, talk to me, what's going on? And I'm able to bring her back down to that level of it's okay. And so the road to acceptance is not fun. The road to acceptance is rough, very, very rough. It's really, really hard to get there. But the biggest thing you need to know is you can get there. You can. And it's okay. Let me dry this up. I'll be right back. All right. So I'm going to play around with my little flower here. I'm just going to play around my little flower. So I hope I've gotten you thinking about what you can do for acceptance and how you can take that acceptance and, you know, learn how to deal with it. It's not easy. But then again, is anything easy? I've never seen anything in my life that's really been easy. It's always been hard to do, hard to deal with, and just, you know, you can do it. You just have to put your mind to it. When you get, you know, down and feel like you're down and out, contact a friend. Get a hold of your support system. Find somebody that you know that's there for you that will, you know, they don't have to say, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm, you know, no. You need somebody that's strong to say, it's okay, you can get through this. You can do it. I have faith in you. You know, today's a bad day. Don't make one bad day ruin your entire life. I mean, that's huge. And, you know, another thing I've learned is that just because today was a bad day doesn't mean tomorrow has to be. It doesn't. You know, yeah, we had a bad day, but it's okay. Everybody has bad days, whether you have chronic illness or not. And if you see somebody that says, oh, I never have bad days, well, they're wrong. Everybody has bad days. It's just the way it is. But, you know, find that support system for yourself and lean on it. You know, and they're going to understand. If they've been with you through this, they're going to understand that, you know, it's okay. I understand you're having a bad day. What can I do to help you? And that's how they will face it. I want to see if it's not going to fit. I got to grab my sticker maker. Hold on. Yeah,
And I'm knocking stuff down. That's normal. All right, so I'm going to take this. I'm going to put it through my sticker-maker. Sticker-maker! Give me a sticker. Yay, I got a sticker! Isn't that cool? This is the coolest little machine. Love it. Ugh. Okay. So now I'm going to take that. This is what I dropped. I don't know. And we're going to put this right here. No, no, no. Don't stick to yourself. No, no, no. I want this cockeyed. Let's go up. Do I want it cockeyed? Yeah, I want it cockeyed. Why? I don't know. Because I do. Because I'm cockeyed. I don't know what else to tell you about the acceptance. I don't know what else to say other than you can do this. You definitely can do this. You know, I hope that you have a supportive figure in your life. I hope that there is someone that you can lean on. And I don't like how I just did that. Alright, that'll work for now. I'm going to go back in with my paintbrush. you know, like I said, acceptance doesn't come overnight. It's baby steps. And a lot of it, I think, I'll be honest with you, I think a lot of the hard part of the acceptance, like, for example, using the scooters in the store or, you know, getting a carryout, it's like a personal, it's like you're embarrassed, okay? And it is. I'm 50 years old. Yeah, I am embarrassed. No, I can't say I am. I was. Not anymore. At this point, I'm like, you know what? If it's going to help me not hurt, sorry. If people look at me funny, well, that's their problem. Again, that chronic illness that's invisible, you know? That's their issue, not mine. But I understand that you can be embarrassed and you can feel so uncomfortable because you don't want to be there. Okay, so what do you do with that? You can take that feeling and be embarrassed and be uncomfortable and walk it and then hurt like heck later. Or you can say to heck with it. You know, I'm going to do what I have to do for my body. And I'm going to use that chair. So, you know, that's part of it. And I understand it. I get it. I totally get it. It's not easy. But let me tell you, once you do get to that point, and you know, it's funny, I call it learning lessons along the way. For example, in Phoenix, I learned a lesson. My scooter at this point goes everywhere with me. And you know what? Or I will be renting wherever I end up. But it's okay. I can do that because that's going to, in turn, give me less pain and I'm going to have a much more enjoyable time. You know, when I went on vacation down to North Carolina recently, my scooter was right in the back of the van with me. We used it several times, although it's having temper tantrums right now, and hubby's got to find out what's wrong with it. But we used it, and that's the way it is. That's the way it has to be. I can't not use it, you know? So, you know, you have to get beyond the embarrassment. You have to get beyond the woe is me. You have to get beyond the asking why. Why me? What did I do? How come it has to be me? Why, you know, do I have to do this? You have to get beyond all that. And until you do, you're going to be stuck in that place. And let me tell you, that place is not a happy place. I get it. I totally understand. You know, I don't like those like that, so I gotta do something different with them. Let's see if this will do it. I don't like that either. Do, 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 do. I'll find something here eventually that's gonna work for it. Let's make them glitter. Let's see if glitter does it. Not really. Don't like that. So, you know, I hope this has helped today. There we go. That's a little bit better. Just to get rid of some of that yellow in there. You know, I hope, you know, I've been able to give you some type of words of encouragement because, like I said, the, you know, where you're at, if you're not in the acceptance zone, you're causing yourself more pain and more heartache, and you don't have to do that. Ooh, I like the smell of that. Smells good. This is a Craft Smart paint pen. I'm crazy. I like the smell of, like, Sharpies. They smell so good. It's funny. My granddaughter said, "Thing, Grandma, they smell so good." Yes, they do. But anyways, so acceptance is a long, hard road. If you have any questions, definitely, you know, get in touch with me. You know, I'll help you the best way I know how. And just so you are aware, I am not a counselor. I am not a therapist. This is my story. These are my opinions. These are my feelings. This is how I have learned to deal with what's been handed to me, which is that chronic pain. So, you know, I'm not a professional. I'm just telling you how I feel and how I've learned to deal with it. And, you know, Hubs is right. He's right. I still have days where it's just, I'm miserable. And, you know, it's okay because I'm human. You know what? Those days when you just can't do it anymore and you just want to curl up on the couch and cry. I actually did that not too long ago. And, you know, it's just because that's where I was at that time. All right. I am not going to do a whole lot more to this today. I kind of want to make it just simple, and that's where it's at this point. So, the road to acceptance. I hope you guys can get there. Like I said, if you have any questions, definitely give me a, you know, shoot me a message if you need to. Private message me. I'll be glad to help you any way I can. And, you know, accepting is not giving up. It means you know that it's time to move on. You're ready to discover what's next in your life. You're ready to look at the next chapter and be happy and have fun and still manage that chronic pain. All right. So I hope everybody has a beautiful day. I hope you've enjoyed this. And I will talk to you again soon. Have a good day. Bye. Hey, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that video. As always, hit like, share, comment. I'll answer any of the comments that you have or questions. And as always, be kind, have fun. That's what life's all about. And happy creating. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.